I am doing my best to not turn into fanboy here. Can you tell I'm kind of trying to contain my energy and emotions here? I am so excited about my guest who's with me on the Jersey Central Newsmaker Hotline. We're getting ready for the return of the Fest for Beatles Fans. Coming back to New Jersey, it'll be in Jersey City, March 29th through 31st at an incredible, incredible venue, the Hyatt Regency Jersey City on the Hudson. And what an event this is going to be. Among the things celebrated, the 40th anniversary of the great album by the band Wings called Back to the Egg. And my guest who is with me right now is a founding member of the band Wings. Of course, you know him from the Moody Blues as well. He's a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. He's going to be performing on the main stage and also an intimate set on the Apple Jam stage as part of the Fest for Beatles Fans. Denny Lane is with me this morning here on WCTC. Denny, good morning. It is Burt Barron. What an honor to speak with you. How are you today?
I'm very well, thanks, Bert. How are you?
Oh, great, great. I'm going to try to compose myself here because I've been a fan for such a long time. And just following your career and your work, my wife says Go Now is still her favorite song of all time. And growing up listening to your music, of course, with Wings over the years and whatnot, and a 40th anniversary celebration of Back to the Egg. In your opinion, Denny, where does that stack up with your work with Wings? Is that something that you feel was maybe one of the best albums you guys did?
Well, you know, it's the only album we haven't remastered yet and put out on London Town. But a lot of young people, fans, like that album, because it's the last album that we did. And we had a new lineup with Lawrence Juber and Steve Holly. And they'll be at the fest as well. So it's going to be a good get-together and be a nice little long set. And, you know, I always like working with those people anyway because I'm still in touch with them quite a lot. So
excellent. Yeah. And catching up on the video there for Again and Again and Again, which was the song that you had sang the lead on that record, and this video of, like, everybody in this endless field of flowers where you filmed this, what was that like? What was the idea behind that video that I saw?
Well, we were in that area making the album. We rented a castle, can you believe it? And that's called a rape field, and it's mustard seed, and it's very, very muddy. And so we were standing there in Wellington boots, and one of the reasons we were laughing so much is because every time I was on camera and Paul was off camera, he kept pushing me and trying to push me over in these, and I was sticking in the mud. So even though it's kind of a sad love song, we were laughing through it all. So that's the memory I've got of it.
Yeah, and I can remember as a kid growing up here in New Jersey seeing a television commercial for Back to the Egg, and I was thinking, well, this has to be a great record because there's a television commercial for it, and it was the album cover with everybody sort of looking at almost sort of like a spaceship sort of setting, and you're looking at planet Earth below you there, and I said, this is a great record. I have to check this out for myself. And my brother, who introduced me to the music of the Beatles and, of course, Wings, I wore out his 8-track because when you had the 8-track, I could hear Getting Closer, and I'd wait a few seconds, and then I'd hit the button and click ahead a couple tracks, and it would take me right to the beginning of the Rockestra theme. And I thought it was a great segue that was happening there. So just awesome stuff. But it's going to be a great time in Jersey City. The Fest for Beatles Fans, it's going to be at the Hyatt Regency Jersey City, March 29th through 31st. Tickets on sale now at thefest.com, or you could call 1-866-THEFEST. And get some tickets for what's going to be remarkable. And you're going to be playing with the other guys in Wings, Denny, when you guys are there later this month, yeah?
Oh, yeah. It's going to be a good, set. And as I said, I've worked with Lawrence and Steve quite a lot over the years, so we know what we're doing. It's going to be good.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And some other projects. You got some stuff going on now that you want to talk about this morning?
Well, yeah, I'm down in Nashville at the moment, and I'm doing Songs and Stories, which is just me and the audience, and I'm telling stories and, you know, going through a lot of the songs that I wrote or co-wrote with Paul and the old Moody stuff. So I'm enjoying doing that, but I also do have some gigs coming up. I've got one at Daryl's house and McLoone's, which is, you know, local, to where we all live in New Jersey, just like you. And I'm doing those in April with my band. And we're doing the band on the Run album and the Magnificent Moody's, which is the first album that I ever did with the Moody Blues. So that's been going down well as a show as well. But as I say, I'm doing the songs and stories. I'm having fun doing that. It's good audience, you know, participation type of show.
Yeah.
I've got another one tonight, yeah.
Oh, great stuff. And just my impression of Wings, like I said, I was born in 68, so I was kind of like a very young kid when Wings was out there. And I just remember these gigantic tours and playing big stadiums and big arenas. And it was such a departure from, I guess, what Paul McCartney had done before, because Wings was like a big-time stadium, arena, rock act, in-your-face kind of band. And it was so much fun. And that was rock and roll at its essence to me. And it had such an impression on me. Was it as fun as you guys made it look, Denny? Was it really that cool all those years there in Wings?
Oh, yeah. I mean, we built up to it. We were doing, you know, large audiences, but never on that scale to that extent. That was a 9-month tour. I mean, supposed to end up in Japan, but it didn't. And so it was the first time I'd ever done anything like that myself. I know the Beatles did do Shea Stadium and a couple of other things, but they'd never really did a stadium tour. So for Paul as well, it was new. And we had a great time. The audiences were amazing. And, they're still playing that rock show now on television. So, I listened to it. I thought, what a good band. You know, it was a lot better than I remembered.
Yeah.
But because, you know, when you look back, you don't realize how tight we were and how well rehearsed it was. But apart from that, it was just great fun to do something like that and to get that reaction.
Yeah, well, no doubt. One of the bands that turned me on to rock and roll, there was no doubt about it, because, like I mentioned, when I was born, the Beatles were kind of like a history lesson to me, but Wings was happening right now. I mean, this is a band that's putting out music now and just slaying them around the world to this day. So Wings and you, Denny, you made rock and roll cool to me, so I can never thank you enough for having that impression on me. Do you do the social media stuff, Denny? Facebook, and people can follow you online, yeah?
Well, yeah. My official fan page is on Facebook, and that's where you can get all the dates that I'm doing. But I'm out there quite a lot now. I'm doing a lot of dates, and I'm enjoying it very much.
As well you should. And that McClune's gig sounds interesting, too. I'm going to take a look at that one, too. But for the Fest for Beatles fans, Jersey City, New Jersey, and it's going to be an incredible 3 days at the Hyatt Regency Jersey City on the Hudson, which is a magnificent waterfront hotel there in Jersey City. Get tickets. They're going fast at thefest.com or call 1-866-THE-FEST. Denny Lane, I can't tell you what an honor it was this morning. I'm going to stop shaking now and let you get back to your day. But, man, what an honor and privilege to speak with a member of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and one of my all-time favorite rock stars. So great to speak with you, and hopefully we can catch up in Jersey City. And, again, I can't thank you enough for the time this morning, all right?
Great. Thank you very much, Bert.